Hello everyone, my name is Anas Patel and you are watching Anas Patel official YouTube channel. Welcome to the part 10 of responsive e-learning website development in PHP with PDO. So guys, in last tutorial we successfully get the subcategory into our database from here. So in this tutorial we are going to display the cat from here inside here. So before wasting of time, let's get start. Okay, so first of all, what we are going to do here, just close this one from here, come back into our oh my god, where is my www folder? Yeah, here it is. Then YouTube e-learning and then admin and then category. Okay, so here after this one, after add, I'm going to create a one table from here with the table tag close, then tr tag close, and inside that tr we are going to use the th, so sr number. Okay, first is sr number, then let's try to copy this one from here by control c, paste it. Okay, and then get a query name. Then after category name, then after edit, delete. Okay, so let's check the output from here. So just look at this now, subcategory. Okay, so we need to design that table in with the CSS. So come back again from here, just need to make some changes from here. Okay, detail, and we give the width of that detail 60%. Okay, then margin, we are going to set the margin auto. Okay, then after, now we doesn't need this margin from here, and we are going to change this width with the 100%. Okay, so now what we are going to do here, we just simply have some table, so its width will be 100%. Okay, refresh that one. Details, have some table. So let's try to refresh it again from here. Okay, so just look at this now. Now our table are coming very well. So now what we are going to do here, we simply give the some margin from the top of that table. So we are going to 2% of margin from the top. Okay, yeah, that's better. Okay, then after, what we are going to do here, add table trtd, oh sorry, th. So th height is 35 pixel, and its background will be has 3 f 5 2 6 7. Refresh it again from here. So just look at this now. Also, we need to change the color of that background. So we are going to change the, oh sorry, text color is fff, which means white color. Refresh that one. We need to remove these spaces from here. So I'm going to come back again here, and here we said cell spacing 0. Refresh that one. So just look at this now. Now it's looking very good, very nice. So now I'm going to paste the detail of that category table inside from here one by one. Okay, so how can we do that? So simply just come back here. After this function, we are going to create one another function with the name view cat. Okay, Then after, first of all, I'm going to include that function from database file ancestor/db.php. Okay. Then after, I'm going to create just copy this one from here. It's because we need that. So copy this one from here, paste that one from here, and that while tag. Oh, sorry, while function from here. And here I'm going to echo the tr again and again with the same td. Okay, td, then double quotes, dot dot, and then dollar row cat name. Okay, so what we are going to done here, just look at here, we fired a query with the select star from cat. We are going to execute that query. We need all the records from here, so for that reason we are running while loop. If you need only one record from this table, so we doesn't need that while loop, but we need a multiple record. For that reason we are running while loop here. And what we are going to do here, just look at this. Now this tr have some all the th, so inside second tr we are going to get some tds with the cat name. Okay, so what we are going to do here, we need to call this function from here to inside after this one. Okay, paste that one from here, and we have to echo that function from here. We are going to echo that function from there. So now let's refresh and check what happened. Just look at this. Now SR number is coming. Okay, just because we have here 4th, and here we have only 1 TD, so for that reason it mismatch. Okay, so come back again here, create one another TD, close that TD from here. And here I'm going to create something, just because we need a SR number 1 by 1 1 2 3 4 5 6, just like that. So $i++, I'm going to explain that one from here. So before this, create one variable with the i = 1. Okay, so when the loop is running, then this time that value is 1. Okay, when the second time loop is running, then 1 + 1 = 2. Then third time the while loop is running, then 2 + 1 = 3. So something like that will be coming from here. So just look at this. Now 1 2 3 development category all are coming from here. Okay, then this one. So then the next one is td close a tag. We need here a tag just because we are going to create a one link with the edit. Okay, here we are writing here edit. Okay, also we need one more link from here with the name delete. So using this link we can edit or delete the data from this table. So just look at this. Now what we are going to do, we need to design something from here. So how can we design that one? So come back again from here and see the text align of the th tag, text align left. Okay, refresh that one again. Oh my god, I'm going to clear the data again. Refresh that one again. So just look at this. Now we are going to use here padding from the left 2%. Okay, refresh that one again. So just look at this. Now it's looking very good. So for same as the same thing we are applied from here, add table tr td, and then height will be 30 pixel, and then padding from the left is also 2%. Also we set the box sizing border box property just because is not mismatched with the table box box sizing, border box again we are going to use from here. Refresh that one. So just look at this now. Now it's looking very good, very nice, and looking beautiful. Okay. So we will decrease the font size from here. Also, we can set that font. So we set font size 14 pixel. Refresh that one. Just look at this now. The font size is decreased now. So we also need to decrease some font size also from here with the font size 40 pixel. Okay. Refresh that one. I think 12 pixel is better one. So 12 pixel. Refresh that. Okay. Now it's looking very good, very nice. We need to remove this one from here. Okay, let's move forward. So I think, guys, this is enough for today. Let's same way we use as the same way from here. So also open the subcat. Where is the subcat? Yeah, here it is, the subcat. Okay, so the same way we are going to apply it from here. So I'm going to again copy this one from here by Control C, paste that one from here by Control V. Okay, SR number, here we are going to set the subcategory name, edit and delete. Okay, so now what we are going to do, we need to here view subcat. Okay, come back into function.php. here we are going to apply it. After this view subcat, okay, then after here we are going to change subcat. Okay, then after, yeah, here subcat name. So let's change here subcat. Yeah, okay. So now let's get the output. So just look at this now, just look at this now, all the subcategory is coming. So but we also get the same main category of that subcategory from there. Okay, so how can we do that? Simply just come back here and create one ID with the dollar row and say cat ID. Okay, so now what we are going to do here, we are going to again create fire one query, get c. Okay, get c. Okay, dollar con prepare statement, and we said double quotes select star from cat where cat ID equal to dollar ID. I'm going to explain that query, but before just first of all write the query. Set fetch mode is PDO fetch SOC. Okay, then after we also need to get that function execute, then after row cat equal to dollar get cat get c, and then fetch function. Okay, so now I'm going to write here one another td with the here after this td close double quotes dot dot dollar row cat, and what's the name of that field, cat name. Okay, and now we also need to here th main category name. Okay, so just refresh this one. So just look at this now. Development design. Okay. Oh, why is marketing? Oh yeah. Refresh it again. Yeah, this subcategory. Okay, just look at here. So when I am going to add something new from here with the development and say web development, add category. Okay, so just look at this now. Web development is coming from here, and then subcategory. So let's add the subcategory from here. Add one subcategory with the, oh my god, oh, we make a mistake from here. We does not that one from here. Development. Okay, we need to add subcategory here from development to web development. Okay, add subcategory successfully. So just look at this now. Web development and development. Okay, so I think guys, this is enough for today. If you guys are like my videos, then like and share my videos, and if you have any question in your mind, then comment below. And don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel, just because when I upload the new videos, then you can get the direct notification into your inbox. So press that subscribe button and hit that bell icon, so you can get the direct notification into your inbox. Okay, so in next tutorial we are going to working on the edit category section from here. We are going to working from here. Okay, so for that tutorial, stay tuned with me, stay connected with me. Thanks a lot for watching guys. See you in next tutorial. Goodbye.